here is a harsh truth. The midterm and short-term rental space is getting incredibly more competitive each and every single day. There are more people entering the space. There's tons of gurus out there telling people how to run these businesses, how to make money. People are buying Airbnbs, short-term and medium-term rentals all the time and entering into the space because of the promise of all the money that they could be making. So now it is more important than ever to find strategies to make your listings stand out, to make your home stand out among the rest so that you get the bookings and you're not stuck with vacancy rates that are eating into your cash flow profits. So today I want to share with you 4 ways to make your listing stand out and some creative ways to make sure that you are staying in the cash flow on your mid and short-term rentals. Hey guys, I'm Andrew Lewis, real estate investor and entrepreneur with over 10 years experience building and growing a real estate team and investing in real estate. Before we get into today's video, please take a minute, hit that like button, don't forget to leave us a comment, and as always, be sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on future updates. I'm here to help you break out of the 9-to-5, gain financial freedom, and grow wealth through real estate. So as I mentioned, it is getting harder and harder to stand out among the rest, and it is more important that you make sure that you do what it takes to make your listing stand out and keep those bookings coming on a consistent basis. So we're gonna start a little bit with some of the basic and move more into the creative, but here are 4 ways to make sure that you keep that passive income coming in on your medium-term and short-term rentals. Number 1 is make sure that you have professional photos of your listing. Do not take cell phone photos. Don't do it yourself. Even if you took photography in high school, I don't care. Leave it to a professional. In some markets, we're talking like $150 to have somebody go in there and take some professional photos for you, edit them, make sure they are light and bright. You need this to stand out among the rest. And honestly, this is becoming an absolute necessity if you want to make any money at all. So don't be cheap here. If we're talking that you're going to make $5,000 to $10,000 a month in passive income off of some of these things, there is no way that you can skimp out on $150 worth of professional photos to make sure that that income continues to come in. So if you don't have those already, make sure that you do. Call around and just ask for a local real estate photographer for that area, and you will find somebody that can do amazing work and make your listings stand out. Number 2 is make sure that you have a unique and well-designed interior. Like I said, these first 2 are a little bit more basic, some generic rules that everybody knows about, but with the space becoming more and more competitive, these have become absolute musts. So make sure that you spend time on design. Have some accent walls, make sure that things stand out and pop, and then make sure that those listing photos also show you some of those features so that people can see the uniqueness to your listing. Find some art and furniture that totally pop in that space and make it stand out. Have some unique features within your home that stand out among the rest. Again, we are not simply just getting a 3-bedroom, 2-bath, putting in a couch, a flat screen TV, and a couple queen bed mattresses. That is not what we're doing here. You could get away with that 5, 6, 7 years ago, but now there are more people entering this space and you've got to stand out. So I suggest that if you don't have a design or an eye for design of your own, that you absolutely bring somebody into this process. Again, we're talking a few thousand dollars for you to make $5,000 to $10,000 a month passively on properties. So this is of huge importance. Do not skimp out on this. You should have somebody come in, help design the space for you. Make sure you've got some things that pop, that stick out to people, because those are going to be featured in that listing to make sure that you get the bookings that you need. Number 3, and this is where we're going to dive into the more creative here, but number 3 is think about the things that you can add as add-ons to your property to make it stand out among the rest. Can you include a car rental for the property? So someone flies into town, all they have to do is take an Uber to your property, and then they've got a car that they can use the entire time rather than paying thousands of dollars from a rental car business. Can you leave bikes if this is an area near the beach, maybe some beach cruisers near the beach so that people can take them out and go ride them? You can include those in your listing so that people can see that. And even if this is a medium-term space, Maybe these bikes are something that can be ridden to work. Maybe you're close to a hospital or a few hospitals and they can save on gas by riding these bikes to work or using this car, especially if it's medium term and you have a car rental there available for them and you're only charging them a few hundred dollars a month on it. That is significant savings for them and it will help them book your property and you'll be making even a little bit of money on top of that car payment. So think creatively. Can you have groceries ready inside of the fridge for that person when they show up? You just send them a quick survey of what they like inside the house and you deliver $150 worth of groceries before they ever get there. Think about the client experience and what you can do different that makes you stand out. This will be something that will give amazing reviews because we all know that reviews are huge on these sites. You need good reviews, you need to be a great host. So think creatively on what else you can add just besides just the house to make sure that you stand out among the rest. And last but not least, this one's probably not gonna be your favorite because you've been thinking passive income the whole time. Number four is get out there and hustle. Don't just rely on websites like Airbnb or Furnished Finder or any of those websites to just have bookings come to you passively. Get out there and make the business happen. If you are running this like a business and you desire to have passive income in the long run, get out there and hustle and find people to rent these properties for longer periods of time, especially the medium term space. You can pick up the phone and call hospitals and talk to the HR department and ask if they have traveling nurses coming in and who the recruiter is that reaches out to them and then reach out to those people and offer your services. Hey, I own several units in the area. I'm sure your clients are spending thousands of dollars on hotels and other things. I would love to offer my units as an added bonus to help you recruit and attract people to your hospital for a certain period of time. How about that? Call insurance companies. People are displaced all the time due to floods and fires and all of those things, and they need to live somewhere furnished for a period of time while that home is repaired. So offer that as a service to insurance companies. Make those connections. Hey, if you see a construction site, sometimes for big, big projects like hospitals and those big malls and things like that, they bring people in from outside areas to do the work. Call the construction company. Hey, do you have workers coming from out of the area? Can I offer you some affordable housing for them? And guess what? You can make great, great money on this because they are paying tens of thousands of dollars to put people in extended stay hotels when you can offer them a home with multiple rooms and you can even charge them sometimes 2, 3, 4 times what you could on the long-term rental side of things to house some of these people. Again, this is going to take some hustle and some work on your side of things, but if you've got the professional photos and the great design and you've got great reviews and the bookings just aren't coming the way you want on some of those sites, then it's time to get to work. If you take some time and set these contracts up with people, your bookings will come in a steady flow and you will never have to worry about waiting for another random booking to come through ever again. The whole point here today is that you need to get creative with how you are running this business. This is not as passive as many people want it to be. You need to actually continue to think about ways to outmaneuver the competition. That is business in general. You don't just open McDonald's and expect that nobody else is ever gonna open a Wendy's or a Taco Bell or a KFC and compete with you. You're going to have to continue to grow, continue to be creative in ways to make your business stand out. And your business here is a short-term or a medium-term rental. You're going to need to stay ahead of the competition. So some of these are absolute necessities. Some of them are more creative to make sure that you get those future bookings, but you need to run this like a business and you're going to have to put some time into it. As much as you want this to be fully passive, it's not a 40-hour a week job, but it is something that you need to be thinking about on a consistent basis to make sure that you're standing out. So take some time to think about these to see which one you could apply to your business, if not all of them, to make sure that you are getting those consistent bookings and making the money that you're looking for. As always, I hope you enjoyed today's content. If you could, take a moment, hit that like button, leave us a comment below, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on future videos. I'm here to help you break out of the 9-to-5, gain financial freedom, and grow wealth in real estate. We'll see you next time.